girl, big boy, superstar DJ. Here we go!
I think there are definite links between consumerism and religion. Some of the functions that used to be assigned to religion in society might have shifted towards consumerism. In religion, people look for some sense of purpose and meaning, and they also find some kind of morality through which to guide their own behavior and action. And you could say that consumerism does something similar, because of all the messages of a consumer society telling people how to behave in order to improve their lives, etc. I think in that broad sense, maybe consumerism provides some of the aspirations that people live in order to try and realize a better life. Religion offers some kind of better life through heaven and the future. Maybe perhaps the idea of a wonderful holiday or something provides something similar, a better self in the future.
Since 1995 to 1996, Australia's retail trade has increased from 34,829 million to 53,242 million in 2005-2006. In 1901, 96.1% of Australians identified themselves as religious. This figure has slowly declined over time, and in 2001, only 68% did, with 15.5% identifying themselves as non-religious, as opposed to 1901's 0.4%.
These days, it's more about what you buy and what you have rather than who you are, and society is very pretentious.
Depends on the individual, but I think probably Generation Y especially are more driven by material things.
The way that the media pumps it up, TV, you know, I've even got one of these damn iPhone things.
In regards to religion, people don't really have much of a religion anymore these days. And it's mainly just, yeah, do whatever I want, whatever makes me happy, and people are very selfish.
I think it's a bit ridiculous. Like, you have to draw the line somewhere. If you see a really nice outfit or something, I'm a bit weak and I might buy it. But other times I might think, oh, you know, it's just so overpriced, probably made in a sweatshop.
If you look at the mass of advertising in the world today, I mean, and forms of marketing communications that aren't obvious advertising as well, we have a wealth of communication that's trying to get us to buy things. And it's very hard to deny that that has effects on people's behavior. In that incessant search for, you know, the sale of products, inappropriate forms and messages are used, and I think it's pretty naive to argue that there are no effects at all, you know, that young people aren't influenced, and it's also pretty naive to assume that they're influenced in some simple way where they just copy or you know, go and live out the kinds of ideals presented to them in advertising.
One of the biggest and increasingly trendy consumer electronics and software manufacturers today is Apple Incorporated. Selling big with Mac computers and iPods, Apple products are among the most popular retail items.
Well, in the last year, I think I've spent probably around $5,000 on Apple products just in general over the computers, iPods and software which I use on a regular basis. As a result of this, it's caused me to pretty much just live more basic than I usually would, purchasing more basic foods, not lashing out on luxury items. Just because I purchase Apple products does not make me a materialistic person, or just computer products in general. A lot of people out there purchase other products to satisfy their materialistic needs, such as cars, suits, handbags, makeup, and all other kinds of stuff. Well, I don't necessarily believe that consumerism has become a new religion. It's just that it's overshadowed the religions of the world today. It's, instead of going to church on Sundays, it's turned into more of a family day where people go out to the shops.
Religion doesn't unify society anymore. Consumerism might have taken over from religion in that unifying role. I mean, it's quite normal in society today to think that consuming and wanting a better life through consuming is what citizens should do, and that's what we all have in common, in a sense. What has happened is that traditional religious organizations demand a certain kind of loyalty, and the people who lead those organizations have a certain kind of authority to control people's beliefs and practices. Consumer society gives out another message about the individual controlling their own life, about choice, about doing what you want and having the freedom to choose. So there's an obvious tension in the sense that consumer society says that individuals have the authority to choose how they live. Traditional religion is about controlling the moralities about how we should live. So for that reason, I think that there's an obvious drift away from traditional religion.
Most young people today very focused on new products and trends and fashions, and basically just buying anything that they can think of. But I don't think that this is the way to happiness and fulfillment. I personally would rather have a faith. I feel as the consumerism goes up, Christianity is going down, all sorts of religion are going down, any sort of spirituality, because people are more concerned with their possessions and playing video games and watching TV and entertaining themselves rather than enjoying life and what it really should be about. Attendance in my church has been going down heaps in recent years, and I do think this is just because people don't care so much about spirituality anymore.
The consumer society is something that's developed in the last 50 years or so after World War II. We didn't really have mass consumer markets in products before that time. So it's a fairly recent historical phenomenon itself. Now, if you look at the realities of climate change and the fact that, you know, it appears that human beings have to radically change their way of living in order to survive as a species over coming generations, the first thing is to question whether the consumer society is sustainable. There might be factors that force us to change the way we live. So who knows in 5 decades' time what the norms will be. The thing I will say about religion is that religion always persists. We are in a secular society where, there's a lot of choice in what you believe, and a lot of people believe that religion is not true. But it always adapts and always changes with society. So my only real prediction is that consumerism itself is a problem, the extent of consumerism, and society has to work out how to change. And as part of that, who knows, religion, the higher immaterial sort of ideas on offer, might be some kind of alternative in the future to consumerism itself.